dirty, but nonetheless, it's not leaking. It's just dirty. We want to keep our load. We want to make sure our bolts are tight, not bent, cracked, or broken. We want to look at the frame of the forklift. We want to make sure the frame is intact. There are no cracks. It's not bent or broken. We'll look at our tires here. Just overall, especially these tires, these are solid tires, so you want to make sure there's not large chunks taken out. We do have a few small chunks taken out, but in all honesty, this isn't the best work environment for this style of tire. We should be using a pneumatic tire, but beggars can't be choosers. We're going to look over here, we're going to look at the forks. I'm going to have to raise this up a little bit so I can get this powered off. Give me 1 second. This powered off now. And now we're going to inspect the forks. We got to look over here, clean them off if we need to, make sure they're not cracked, they're not bent, broken. We want to especially pay attention over here to this portion of the fork, because this is where all the strength is when you're lifting and everything. You want to make sure there's no cracks along the way, make sure there's no flat spots, no dents. We want to continue on. We want to make sure that we have movement in here when you release the pin. Make sure it doesn't get bind, wound up, locked into place, it doesn't move. We want to continue. You want to make sure all your welds are good, they're not broken, because then that will be a structural integrity problem. You want to keep on looking. Come over to this hydraulic portion. Make sure it's not leaking. And then again, it's just, this one's dirty again. Go ahead and inspect their tires again. Note, we got a couple chunks missing. Now we want to look at the frame of the fork truck. We want to make sure, once again, our welds don't crack, it's not broken. Tires. Once again, noted there's some gouges in these tires. Now this vehicle right here, this is where the counterweight is. This portion is the counterweight. This is what counters whatever you're picking up in front. And the weight that this forklift is able to pick up, you can find right here. This is the identification plate that gives you all the information that you need on the fork truck. Lifting capacity, and everything of that nature. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to lift this up and we're going to inspect where the engine is. You want to look over here. This is where the hydraulic breather is. Not only is this a fill cap, but it's also a breather. It's a little dirty, but nothing too crazy right now. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to put this cap back. Check our hydraulic fluid. And we're not quite to add, but we're a little low. But for all intents and purposes, we're pretty good right here for now. And then it's going to be an overall general inspection of the engine compartment. You want to make sure there's no debris, it's not too dirty. You want to note any broken wires, inspect the battery connections. I'm going to go ahead and pull the oil dipstick. Four. looks like we're right in range. The oil on this is good. Now we're just about done here. We're gonna look, inspect the seat. But obviously, we wanna make sure that it's still got good cushion here. Because if you don't, riding in this thing all day, cause back problems. So you want to make sure that you have a good place to sit. We're going to come over here real quick. This is where our exhaust is. We want to make sure this is free and clear of all debris. Our tow hitch, in case you ever need to pull something, you want to make sure that's there. We're going to inspect this last tire right here. That's looking pretty good. Not too beaten up. Now we're going to go into the actual operation of the fork truck. We're going to hop up in here. We're going to go up, down, tilt forward, reverse, make sure our lights work, and our blinker on the top works. Safety first. We're going to hook up our seatbelt. Make sure the truck's here. If this was a cold start, we would turn the key to the left. Allows the low ones to warm up, and then about 10 seconds to be able to start it. But we're here in Florida, it's a pretty warm day, so we're going to be able to start this bad boy right up. As you can see, it started up nicely. Our safety light is on, which allows everybody in the vicinity to know that this fork truck is now on and the operation ability. I'm going to see reverse right here. Alright, our reverse horn works, so that allows everybody, the motor to be here, that the fork truck is now moving. We're going to go forward now. We're going to lift up the e-brake. Go down the e-brake. And we're moving good. Let's do it. Motion. Tilt back forward. All the way up, and then when I go to drop it, it should drop within 9 seconds. If it doesn't, then that means that I have a hydraulic blockage of some sort. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to, yep, there you go. So we're gonna see if we can bring this bad boy down to 9 seconds. Let's count out together. One, two, three, four, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. All three came down within 9 seconds, so therefore, we do not have a blockage in our hydraulic system. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna put these forks back in the pallet, and we should be done at that point.